Let's take up mechanism of elimination reaction. Like substitution reaction, elimination reaction can also be unimolecular and bimolecular, that is E1 and E2. In E1 reactions, alkyl halide first forms the carbonium ion. In the same manner as SN1 reaction, carbonium ion or carbocation so formed loses a proton rapidly to form alkenes or olefins. Let's take up example. The first step is slow step because bond is being broken. Br negative will get separated and will get primary carbocation. Now this primary carbocation nucleophile is going to abstract a proton from beta carbon, from this carbon, and when the proton is abstracted, the pair of electron will take part in double bond formation. Propene will be formed plus water will be formed. This step is faster. The rate of these reactions is independent of the concentration of OH ions because in slow step only alkyl halide is involved. That is why it is E1 mechanism. Let's take up evidence for the E1 mechanism in this case. Effect of structure on the reactivity of alkyl halide. Tertiary is more reactive than secondary, is more reactive than primary, is more reactive than methyl halide, which clearly shows that the carbocation is formed because tertiary carbocation is most stable and methyl carbocation is least stable. Rearrangements. E1 reactions are liable to rearrangements, that is, rearrangement may take place because primary may change to secondary, secondary may change to tertiary carbocation, which are more stable. Let's take up an example. This is primary alkyl halide neopentyl bromide. First step, Br negative is lost and we get neopentyl carbocation. Now here rearrangement can take place by methyl shift. So this methyl group shifts to this position, so this positive charge will shift to tertiary carbon. So we get 2-methylbutyl carbocation or tertiary carbocation. Now there will be abstraction of proton from beta carbon, from this carbon, so that the alkene which is formed has got maximum alkyl group or most substituted. So 2-methyl-2-butene is the major product. So here the product has been formed through a rearrangement by methyl shift, which resulted in converting primary carbocation to tertiary carbocation. Next example we are taking is E2 mechanism. Where E2 mechanism will be applicable? First, we have taken normal propyl bromide and we are reacting it with OH ion. So OH ion attack from this side, it starts forming bond and acquires a delta negative charge. Bond between carbon and bromine starts breaking and bromine also acquires negative charge. This is called intermediate state where new bonds are half broken and old bonds are half broken and new bonds are half formed. So it is called transition state. It's highly unstable. And the next step is fast step. Ultimately, this water is gone and here Br is gone. So here double bond will be formed, resulting in the formation of propene. Evidence for E2 mechanism we are going to take up. First is absence of rearrangement. No rearrangement takes place in E2 mechanism. It means it does not involve carbocation. It involves both alkyl halide and nucleophile in the same step. That is why the rate of reaction depends upon concentration of nucleophile as well as alkyl halide, and no rearrangement takes place. Next, we are taking isotopic effect. When isopropyl bromide reacts with ethoxide ion, we get propene. Now here we have taken deuterated isopropyl bromide, that is, this hydrogen has been replaced by deuterium. So here DBr is removed, that is Br from here and T from here is removed with the help of ethoxide ion, and the product formed is CD2 double bond CH and CD3. That is, we get deuterated propene. So it clearly shows that here carbocation is not formed. Rather, here direct nucleophile is abstracting proton. Because proton is being abstracted, that is why this is being replaced by deuterium. Orientation in the elimination reaction. Now, orientation means if you have 2 halopentane, there are 2 possibilities. One possibility is that X is removed from here and H is removed from here and we get 2-pentene. 2-pentene being more stable, it will be major product, and this is called Setzef elimination. More alkyl substituted alkene will be the major product. Here it is Hoffman elimination where least substituted alkene will be formed. Cl from here or X from halogen from here and H from here will be removed, resulting in the formation of 1-pentene which is listed. The properties of the two pentenes vary as follow. The proportions of two pentene vary as follows. If there is iodopentane, we get 80% and 20%. If bromo is there, it's 81 and 19%. Chlorine 65 and 35. In fluorine, it becomes opposite. The two pentene becomes a minor product and one pentene becomes major product. E2 reaction proceeds in one step in which CH bond and CX bonds are broken in the same transition state, and various bond strength are like this. CH bond requires 435 kilojoules per mole. CF requires 452 kilojoules per mole, which is higher. CCl bond requires 351. It is higher than CH bond. And 351 kilojoules per mole. CBr has 293 kilojoules per mole. CI is weaker, 234 kilojoules per mole. So when CH bond and CX bonds are both broken to a considerable extent, the E2 transition state will have considerable alkene character, and the factors that stabilize an alkene, that is maximum alkyl groups will stabilize the alkene, they will play the role. So such an E2 reaction in which transition state has considerable alkene character will proceed by Setzef orientation, that is more alkyl substituted alkene will be the major product. But if the cleavage of CH bond takes place first, as in case of fluorine, because here bond dissociation energy required is more. So first this bond will break, then this bond will break. So E2 transition state will not have alkene character to large extent. It will have little alkene character, and negative charge will dwell on the carbon, losing the proton from the CH bond. So E2 transition state will have carbanion ion character, and thus transition state will be stabilized by electron withdrawing groups and destabilized by electron releasing group. Let's take up the example. Here we have got fluorine group attached here, and here we have got hydrogen attached to bromine. This is more stable because fluorine is electron withdrawing group. Here it is less stable because negative charge is on the carbon it is not be able to stabilize it, and it is rather destabilized by both the alkyl groups. Here we have got one alkyl group which is destabilizing it. Here we have got two alkyl groups which is destabilizing it. Fluorine is present in both. So this one is less stable as compared to this one. This is more stable. When the cleavage of CX bond, CI bond exceeds greatly that of CH bond, the carbon losing X will develop a positive charge and E2 transition acquires cationic character. Here it is linked with iodine. It acquires positive charge and it is more stable. Whereas here, if we have got iodide, this is less stable as compared to this one. In the series I, Br, Cl and F, CX bond becomes stronger and the carbanion ion character of the transition state increases. The anionic transition state is further stabilized by electron withdrawing effect of halogens. This explains the decreasing Setzef orientation in I, Br, Cl and F. So in fluorides, Setzef orientation does not take place and one pentene is the major product. The orientation in E2 reaction is affected greatly by nature of the base and the solvent used in the reaction. For example, here we have got 3-chlorohexane. When we use methoxide ion, that is methyl alcohol and sodium methoxide, it gives one hexene at only 36%. But if you use potassium tertiary butoxide and tertiary butyl alcohol as a solvent, one hexene is formed to 90%. So here Setzef elimination is taking place, here Setzef elimination is not taking place. So here the solvent is tertiary butyl alcohol, here solvent is methyl alcohol. Here sodium methoxide is used, here potassium tertiary butoxide is used. So the E2 mechanism is affected by base and solvent. Let's take up important points. E2 reaction predominates as the structure of alkyl halide changes from primary to tertiary, while SN2 will predominate as one moves from tertiary to primary. This is the competition between elimination and substitution. E2 reactions more frequently dominate with the strongly basic reagents such as amide ion or alkoxide ion, the tertiary butoxide ion, while weakly basic reagents like acetate ion and iodide ion will favor SN2 reactions. Solvent of high polarity and reagents of low nucleophilic power favor SN1 reactions, while solvents of low polarity and reagents with high nucleophilic power favor elimination. The term solvolysis has been used for the nucleophilic substitution reaction in which the nucleophile themselves are solvent. For example, water is a solvent as well as nucleophile. Methyl alcohol is solvent as well as nucleophile. The solvents like dimethyl sulfoxide and dimethyl formamide, which are highly polar but they do not contain acidic hydrogen, they are called aprotic solvent because they do not give proton or H positive ion. This is the structure of dimethyl sulfoxide. This is dimethyl NN dimethyl formamide. The nucleophilic reactions which proceed rather slowly in common protic solvents proceed much faster in aprotic solvent. Protic solvent solvate anions, that is nucleophile, through hydrogen bonding and at the same time decreases the basicity or nucleophilicity of the reaction. Hence, the reactivity of nucleophile is decreased. In contrast, aprotic solvents containing no acidic hydrogen fail to solvate the anion, that is nucleophile, and net result is that the unsolvated anion can behave as highly reactive nucleophilic reagents, nucleophilic reactions.